nothing ever will. Tried to stay sober, tried to stay clean. Let me when it's over, like a bad dream. The bad news, however, is that it won't be as a group. I'm told Emma Bunton has secretly been working on solo material in the hope of making a pop comeback. It's 11 years since the Heart Radio DJ released All I Need to Know, which was her last solo single. But my source claimed Emma has been secretly working on new music. She really enjoyed being back in the studio with Jerry and Mel B when they were originally planning the Spice Girls comeback under the alias of Jem. Although the project never saw the light of day, it made her realize how much she misses singing. Seeing former Eternal singer Louise Redknapp performing again has also been a motivating factor. It's very early days, but a solo project is underway. Emma enjoyed 7 top 10 singles as a solo star, including 2001's number 1 What Took You So Long, and Baby's Not the Only Spice, hoping to reignite her solo career off the back of the group's reunion. The band's biggest solo star, Melanie C, is already hard at work on her 8th studio album, and Jerry Horner is once again threatening to bring out new music. My source said, the five won't be performing material together for their comeback, but expect a few of the girls to release solo stuff shortly after. The Spice Girls' big comeback is surrounded in secrecy, but fans have been warned that the chart toppers won't be performing together. A talent show in China or a documentary film celebrating their careers are being rumored. Vogue Williams says she would not be engaged to Spencer Matthews if she had watched Made in Chelsea. The reformed love rat proposed to the Irish model this week, and Brian McFadden's ex-wife joked, "I never watched Made in Chelsea. Thank God, a friend of mine sent me a highlights clip of him, and I don't think would be here if I had seen it. He's not that man anymore though. He's grown up and changed." The pair are so loved up, Spencer has even cured Vogue of her long-term anxiety attacks. Well, that's what her future hubby thinks anyway. Vogue said, "My anxiety is really good at the moment. Spencer likes to attribute it to him, and who knows, he could be right. It could be because I'm loved up and happy." Fitness fanatic Vogue is an ambassador for Blackcurrant sports supplement Currents, which supports health, performance and recovery. She added, "I'm training 6 times a week at the moment, and it's really helping." Towie Torso Charlie King wants to swap S for a remote jungle. The hunky personal trainer wants to test out his survival skills on the next series of Bear Grylls' Celebrity Island. Charlie, currently starring on MTV's Beach Body SOS, told me, "I would love to do Bear Grylls or I'm a Celebrity. I love challenging myself." Charlie was in talks to do a fitness spin-off with Gemma Collins as she attempts to lose weight for a baby. He said, "We had some meetings with a production company, but Gemma is a bit too busy ruling the world at the moment." Talking about babies, Charlie added, "I would love kids. I'm focused on being successful so I can offer a kid a stable future." MTV's Beach Body SOS continues on Wednesday at 8 p.m. Lewis Walsh had better watch out because Craig David is eyeing his place on the X Factor judging panel. "The I Know You singer told me, I think I could mentor people in a good way and bring something new that hasn't been seen before. I've been in the industry for almost 20 years. I've had highs and lows and really believe I could offer some great advice." Picking X Factor over The Voice, Craig added, "I think Will.i.am embodies The Voice He owns that show and has his thing there, but I think X Factor is interesting. Craig's new record, The Time Is Now, is number 2 in the album charts, blank, underscore, blank. Beyoncé is about to drop a new record to run the world once more. The pop goddess is finishing off her 7th studio album, which music insiders claim will be released ASAP. My source said, Beyoncé's last two albums have been quite dark, but the new record is far lighter with some big anthemic tunes. She's in a happy place and it comes across in her music. Details of the new record have been a well-guarded secret, but I'm told, Beyoncé will drop the album unexpectedly before she headlines Coachella in April.